hey, hey, all my work from home buddies. I see you on your Zoom call getting all fidgety and slouchy and distracted and bored. And I also see you wearing your yoga clothes under your smart blazer and ties. So, next time you have that 20-minute stretch break, we're gonna do this. We're gonna work through those parts of the body that get tight and restricted and feeling, create some openness and space. We're going to get a nice little break somewhere towards the end, but then I'll make sure that we get back up and we get energized, ready to go back to work. All right, so lose the blazer. I know your yoga clothes are ready. Don't worry, you're not fooling anyone. And let's start. So we're going to take the arms wide. So the front of the chest, front of the shoulders tend to get tight. So reach out through the fingertips, reaching up and back with the heart, maybe even looking up. And then let's drop the left hand down, reaching it down towards the ground, reaching the right arm up towards the ceiling. Starting to feel the stretch into the right side of the body. Maybe even let the hips push towards the right as you're reaching through both hands. And then let's do a little movement with the chest forward and back. Kind of a cat-cow type movement. Just starting to move all of these joints that may have been getting stiff and tired. We'll do a little rotation as well. Bringing one side of the ribs forward and then back. Good, reach. We'll come back through center, let's give a little hug. And then open out again, reach through the fingertips. And then we'll drop the right hand down, left arm reaches up, pushing out through the left hip, reaching through both fingertips, up and down. And then we'll start that movement with the chest. Cat, cow, flexing and extending. We have over 100 joints in the spine between all of the ribs and our facets and discs. And we want to get those ends moving. Let's rotate. Adding the breath. One more stretch. We'll come back through center. Reach around. Right arm's in front this time. Give a little hug. And then we'll take shoulder rolls back. Big, juicy shoulder rolls. Maybe even bending in the knee. Roll through the elbows. And then the wrists all the way up. And then we'll bring the hands into prayer. We're going to do some work for the wrist and the forearm muscles. So take the hands down as far as you can. We're stretching this side of the forearm. So you might feel a stretch there. Maybe you want a little bit more, and you can use one hand to extend the palm and the fingers of the other just by pressing, and then pressing into the other fingers and palm, creating more extension. So just go as far as the wrist can do. No need to over push, but these are definitely muscles that could get tight, overworked while we're doing computer work, phone work, etc. For some reason, I'm swaying my body too, I don't know. Okay, that feels pretty good. Give it a light little shake, and then we'll go the other side, so the backs of the hands together. And here, I'm trying to bring the hands up while the elbows go down. So we're stretching this side of the forearm. So we're pressing the backs of the hands together, trying to bring the wrists up higher as the elbows go down. Good, shake it out, shoulder rolls. Let's stretch the front of the neck. So we'll go just underneath the clavicle on the left side, both hands, place it down. So we're under the collarbone here. And we're gonna press in and pull down as we lift our chin up towards the ceiling. So this is a little myofascial release for you. And then we can move the chin side to side. I wanna feel the stretch along the front of the neck. Breathing. And then we'll go to the other side, place the hands, the palms into that muscle, pulling it down as we take the chin up, moving the head slightly. And you just find those areas of pull. There's this sheet of a muscle on the front of the neck called the platysma. And we're stretching. stretching that. So we're finding the areas where the pull is, giving it a little extra stretch. Nice, drop the chin to the chest. Roll one ear to the shoulder, little half roll side to side. And if you'd like, take a roll all the way around. And then back to the other side. Okay, let's step right foot forward, left foot coming back into warrior one, but we're gonna do a little modification. So turn the back toes in. I know, seems weird. We never do this in yoga, but it's a great way to actually get these hip flexors open, and that's what gets tight when we're sitting. So we're going to just start by pulsing in and out of this stretch. So the back toes are turned in, the heels down, we're pulsing in and out. And then we're gonna take the hips side to side. What are we doing? I know, but I promise it will help it feel better. Okay, then we're gonna reach the hands back and up. So we're using the arms to stretch the front of the body, stretch the front of the hip, and then we'll take the arms side to side. Still breathing. Opening up this whole front line that gets tight and short when we're sitting for a long period of time. This is what will save your lower back, your shoulders, your neck if you're having to sit. Let's move to warrior two. And we'll go into a reverse warrior, opening up that whole side of the body. And then let's come down to side angle and just move back and forth between those two. So creating a little flow and movement. Reverse, side angle. One more time into reverse. If we've been sitting, we want to just create movement and flow. Let's straighten the front leg, moving into triangle pose. Gaze looks up towards the ceiling. Couple breaths here. And then we're gonna bring that hand down, moving into revolve triangle. So adjusting the back foot, turning the toes forward, placing the hand down, or maybe on a block, stack of books, desk, whatever you need, revolve triangle. Hand comes down, come forward into forward fold. Shake it out. And then we'll slowly round up through the spine. Starting to feel warm, vital, alive, little shoulder roll. And then we'll step the right foot back. Finding that warrior one, gonna do the same modification. So the back toes turn in. And then we're gonna bring the hips forward and back. So just kind of popping into the lunge a little bit more. And then we'll stay forward and take the hips side to side. So we're working on opening up, creating some release and function in the front of the right hip flexors. Good, then we'll stay there. And this time take the hands back, reaching, feeling the length through the front of the abdominals down into the front of the right leg. And then with the reach, if you are able, go side to side. Still breathing, can you still breathe here? That is the real challenge. All right, back through center. We'll come now into warrior two. Find some of that steady strength, power, and then reverse warrior. Coming down for side angle. Find that flow, freedom, movement. Feel the breath moving the body. One more reverse. We'll straighten the front leg, moving into triangle. Gaze can turn towards the ceiling. And then we'll bring the hand down. We're switching the feet for revolve triangle. So we don't tend to do a lot of twisting or rotations if we're sitting all day. So it's great to move the body through these different planes of motion. Rotation, side to side. Good, come down, coming into our forward fold. Let the head hang, a little shake, yes, no. Oh, my tie's gonna fall off, oh no. Maybe the arms up and over the back. Loosen the knees. And round up. All right, so back to the wall. We're gonna spend a little bit more time chest and shoulders again. So a couple feet from the wall, I'm gonna reach my arm back. The fingers are pointing kind of up and back behind me. We'll start with the left hand against the wall. So the hand is not directly behind me, it's actually even a little bit farther over. I'm looking to stretch the front of the left shoulder there. So I'm gonna use my body, once I just start, I get it on the wall, I start turning in the opposite direction until I feel the stretch I wanna feel in the front of the left shoulder, the front of the left chest. And then I can just do little turns of my body, kind of pulsing towards the right, creating a little stretch. And then I can do some side bends or kind of side movements with my hip and my shoulders. And that's because the arm is stationary, then I'm gonna put a little bit of movement, rotational movement through the musculature of the shoulder. I may feel it all the way to the fingers, elbow, shoulder, and chest. Great. Shake that out. We'll take the other arm back. So fingers are kind of reaching up and back behind. And once I get the hand situated, I'm gonna then start turning my chest in the opposite direction, in this case to the left. And I'm trying to bring the right rib cage forward and to the left. So I put a stretch into the muscles at the front of the right shoulder and the right chest. I'm feeling it all the way back my arm, even back to my fingertips. And then I can add those little kind of pulses. And then also the side-to-side movement with the hips. Nice. Shake that out. Even if just noticing your posture now, you should be starting to feel your shoulders are feeling more open, relaxed back and down, rather than everything crunched forward. So we want to get the abs open, the hip flexors open, front of the shoulder. Good. Let's take the fingertips down now. Behind us, so this is a stretch kind of for biceps and into the shoulder again. Fingers are down, the arms kind of right behind me, and then I'm going to use my knees lowering down to feel that stretch. Don't overstretch or overstrain anything, just go to where you get that sensation. We want a sensational sensation, not pain. A couple of those, shake it out. Go to the other side, fingertips down, turning back towards the front, and then just going up and down, raising and lowering. I learned this from my husband. I will give him credit. He's very smart. Okay, good. Coming back around, whoa, arms are starting to feel great. One more for the thoracics and the abdominals. So take the, we'll be maybe just a little bit closer to the wall than you were. We're gonna take the left hand, fingers are pointed down, and it's just directly behind me, there, on the wall. So I'm already starting to rotate towards the wall. Now I'm gonna take my right arm and reach it up and over towards the wall. So I'm rotated that way, and my back, my thoracic spine, this upper portion is extended towards the wall. Now look up, can you breathe here? And take the hips side to side. Whew. Use the breath to create space in the thoracic spine, in the abdominals, movement through the rib cage. Very good. And then we'll turn to the other direction. So now the right hand comes behind, fingers are facing down, so I'm rotated towards the right, and the left arm reaches up and over. Finding the wall, like I'm sort of doing a sideways back bend. So I'm feeling stretch through here, stretch through the front of the ribs. And then I'm gonna look up. If I look down, I might kind of cheat myself out of the stretch. So I wanna look up, so I'm really extending in the thoracic spine, add that side-to-side movement of the hip. Breathe. You're probably wondering why you did this video. But I was wearing a tie, so you had to. Oh, and then feel how nice that feels in the thoracic spine. Open, released. Maybe even you feel your lower back kind of relaxed down. All right, let's come back to the front of the mat, head down into a yogi squat. Finding that breath again. again. Let's place the right hand down and reach up with the left. Come back through center. Place the left hand down and reach up. Back through center. Put the hands down. We're going to step back with the left foot, low lunge. Back knee down. Let's reach up. And then drop the right hand down. Reaching up and over. So trying to open up through the left side, the front of the abs, the left hip flexor, all these things that need more space, the side of the ribs. Maybe even you want to go forward and back a little. Back through center. We're going to bend the back knee, reaching up with the right hand, drawing the foot towards the hip. Stretching the quadricep muscle now, the front of the thigh on the left leg. Bringing the hip towards the heel. Keeping the chest up. Maybe even take the gaze up a bit. You can even move the hips around a little. Get a slightly different line of pull. So I'm taking my hips side to side. Okay, take that back. We're going to step over to a side stretch, wide leg side stretch. Wide leg forward fold, Prasarita. Okay, all 10 toes facing this way, pigeon toed in. Coming down, maybe walk the hands through if you want, reach out for the feet. Drive the crown of the head towards the mat, hips reaching up towards the ceiling. And we'll bend into the back knee, coming into a ninja squat. Even take a long stretch here, reaching the left arm out, right arm up. Gonna come back through that wide-legged forward fold. Walking the hands back to the front, just a dip through pyramid pose. And then place the right foot back with the left, headed to down dog. Coming into tabletop, we'll take a couple rounds of cat-cow. Moving with your own breath, finding nice fluid, supple spine, flexible spine from top to bottom. So all the way from your tail to the top of your head is involved in this movement. Coming down onto the belly now. Little baby cobra, you see this theme of trying to open up the front of the body, front of the chest, front of the neck. Let's take the head side to side. So often when we're sitting, our back and our shoulders hurt, and so we stretch those, but what we really need to be doing is stretching the front of the body. Great. We'll take a little wider, up into a deeper cobra. Or up dog. And then press back into child's pose. Rock the hips side to side. And roll up in child's pose. We're gonna do a little something for the eyes since you're maybe staring at a computer. So rub your hands together. They're probably pretty warm right now, mine are. And then take the heel of your hand, kind of the palm, and just put it right into your eyes. So close your eyes, obviously. And let your eyes totally relax. So the heel of your hand, nice and warm, we're putting it right over the eye socket. You can drop your head forward a little bit. So you're holding it in your hands. And just let your eyes be soft in the eye socket. So don't press into the eyeballs with your hands. Imagine actually that you're just kind of creating this nice little space for your eyes to relax into. We have all these little muscles that control the movement of our eyes. And they get tense, and that can create our tension headaches, or it can create strain in the eyes and our vision. So just as you take some deep breaths, creating this little cup for your eyes, see if you can Imagine and experience your eyeballs relaxing in the socket, like they're just hanging forward. And in fact, they have a nerve, the optic nerve that comes out of the back of them, and they are kind of dangling from your brain. Too much? That's okay. So maybe you even feel your brain heavy into your hands here. Take a couple breaths. Good, and we'll bring the head back up. And let's rub the jaw, you can open the eyes. Rub along the jawbone, the masseter muscle. So just let the jaw open and close, relax. Like it's melting open. Another place we hold a lot of tension, right in these jaw muscles. Great. Down dog. Walk the feet forward for forward fold. And we'll come back into our yogi squat. Look up, head side to side. Maybe a little twist side to side. And then we'll step back for the lunge, low lunge on the with the left foot forward. First coming up into our side stretch here, bending over towards the left. You can find the ground or a block or a desk to lean on. But what I'm really thinking of is length and space in the right side of the body, the front of the abdominals, the side of the abdominals on the right, even in the shoulder. So even creating space through here as I'm leaning, using the arm as a weight to create that space. Good. Coming back down, we'll bend the back knee in. Pull the heel towards the hip. Sitting the hips down. And I want to keep my chest up, my body up. So if I do this, I'm going to lose the benefit. So I'm just going as far as I can to feel that sensation in the front of the right leg, the right quad. Good. Let it go back. And then I'm going to turn to the side. Wide-legged forward fold. Do something different with the arms, maybe like reach up and over the back. Maybe you want to add a little rotation twist in here. Just whatever's feeling good, or rock side to side. Explore your body, find those little adjustments that work. Then we'll sit down towards the back leg, bringing the front toes up. And we could reach the right arm out, left arm up. Coming back through our prasarita. Crown of the head towards the mat. Coming into downward facing dog. Just stopping through. Maybe you want to walk the feet out side to side, move side to side. And then come into our tabletop. This time I'm gonna suggest we go side to side. You can just do traditional cat-cow if you want, but I wanna work my spine through that side motion as well. So I'm gonna take one shoulder towards the hip and then the other, and include the head and the tail in the whole motion. Or maybe you wanna think of an S-like snake. All those little joints moving. Lubricating, flowing freely and easily. Nice. And then let's do a traditional cat-cow back through center. Coming down onto the belly. So you could just do cobra here. I think I'm going to take a bow pose. So reaching back for the heels. You can grab inside, outside, whatever you like. And then we'll kick into the hands. So this is going to kind of accomplish a lot of what we've been working on today, opening the shoulders, opening the chest, a little opening in the abs, and also the front of the hip and the leg. So feeling the whole front of the body get a nice opening, lengthening stretch while taking some pressure off the back of the body. And we'll come down. Press back into our child's pose. Rock the hips side to side. Okay. We're gonna leave the right knee forward. Oh, come towards the top of your mat, child's pose. Take the right knee forward. We'll just send the left leg back. We're gonna work our way to a spinal twist. So I'm gonna roll onto my left hip. Keep the right knee bent. Yeah, you might head off your mat a little bit. And then we'll find ourselves in a twist. Winding down, finding a little bit of rest, release into the floor. And let the body be heavy. So as you breathe here, any spots of tension you find, see if you can just breathe into them, bring a little ease, a little release. We're gonna roll all the way onto our backs, knees into the chest, circle. Place the feet down, we'll press into a bridge. Rolling down, let's release the feet up towards the ceiling, sleeping tiger. Shake it out, might even brush down the legs a little. Just encouraging lymph flow, venous return. Like the veins, not the planet. Good, knees into the chest. Bring the right knee in and just turn back to the mat. And left knee comes in, child's pose, rock side to side. This time we'll release the other knee out. I bet I need to move this. And then we're gonna find that roll in the other direction. So now the left knee is in, we're in a spinal twist as we release the left arm out to the side, maybe gaze turns to the left. And again, just find that surrender into gravity. So let go of anywhere where you're pulling or efforting. And see if you can just rest, release. We'll roll back around, onto the back, circle the knees, place the feet down for a bridge, pressing the hips up, roll down, and again, sleeping tiger, or if you want to take a headstand, I think now's a great time for a headstand. We have the wall right here. Always nice to get upside down. Still breathing. Pressing into the mat. Get some blood back in the brain, maybe see things differently. I don't think I've ever recorded this and while teaching it, so that's fun. Maybe try that. Come into child's pose if you are in a headstand, or just bring your knees into the chest. If you were on sleeping tiger still, either way, let's find our way onto the back. So here's our 30-second rest. We can't go to sleep because we still have work to do. We have to get back on that call or conference or whatever we're doing. So we have to take a little micro rest, okay? So find for yourself what's most nurturing. Maybe hand on the heart, hand on the belly. Maybe you just want to be everything relaxed down. Maybe you want to curl in a ball on your side. Close your eyes. See if you can keep yourself present in your body, in your space,
not jumping to whatever's coming next or whatever you have to do, but give yourself this 30-second rest. So maybe you just attend to the breath. Feel the belly rise, the chest rise, and then feel it relax and fall. Feel yourself supported by the ground. Feel that you are held, that you are supported. Feel that vitality in your body. Grateful for the energy that we were able to just exert, and also the energy that we just built up. Letting ourselves find that state of being energized, feeling alive, and yet also relaxed, present, calm, grounded. Three more breaths. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Open your mouth, sigh. One more, inhale. And then exhale. Okay, take a long stretch, fingers to toes, not quite there yet. Gotta get energized again to get back in action. Squeeze in a little ball. We're gonna roll ourselves up. Coming up through chair, through standing, however you want to get there. Come to stand, come all the way up on the tiptoes. Shake the hands, shake the arms, bringing them down. Shake the shoulders, come down on the heels. Shake the upper body, yes, do it. Shake, 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 shake to the side. Shake forward. Shake the hips, shake the legs. Giving everything a good vibrate. Make some sound. Great. Then we'll use our fingertips. We'll tap around the lungs. Both sides. Tap, 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 tap. Tapping around the heart. Tapping around the shoulder, the neck, the head. Waking everything up. Tapping gently the face. And then we'll rub down the jaw again. Of course, we've washed our hands very well before touching our face. And then rub down the neck. Good. Big shake it out. And you are ready to go back to work. Thanks for joining. See you soon.